Hey everyone, today I want to show you one of the easiest ways to stretch your hips. A lot of people struggle in this area because they have to sit down all day and it tends to flare up their sciatic nerve, which we know isn't fun. If you've ever been to yoga class, one of the most common stretches they do is called the pigeon stretch. But if you have bad mobility of your hips, it is a tough stretch to perform. So this is an easier way to get into that stretch, and I like this version a lot better. All you need is a tall box and something like an Eric's pad or something similar that's a little bit squishy. And what we're going to do is get in the same position that we see in yoga, and it's the pigeon. Now we're going to go ahead and we're going to lift one leg up and we're going to drop that leg down. Now, the closer this leg is to a right angle, the deeper the stretch I'm going to feel in the hip. If your hip is really tight, you might not have a right angle and your heel might be off the ground and you might have a slight bend in your knee. That is okay. We just want to get uncomfortable for about a minute or two. If you have really bad hips, this is not a fun position to be in, so I want you to breathe. And then I want you to think about making yourself as tall as possible. So we don't want to hunch, we want to make ourselves tall. And over time, once I start to feel that hip release and that side nerve calm down, I can start to take my back leg, drop the heel, and just hang out here. Now, once we've spent enough time in this position, we're going to do a couple forward bows or leans. But the cool thing is we're not just going to do it in one direction like they do in yoga. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to bow forward. Now, when I bow, we don't want to round our back, and we want to keep an arch in our back. And at the same time, I'm going to think I'm crushing a soda can between my front shin and my chest. You can grab onto the pads, you can grab onto your knees, or one of the best ways is to go with your body weight and just fold forward. Now, I'm going to stop if I start to feel my low background. I'm going to hang out here. I can even perform repetitions. If you need to, of course, grabbing the box is not the end of the world, but remember, keep the chest big and proud and try to arch that back. Now, what we're going to do next is we're going to change the angle of our bow because we want to hit the different parts of the hip and hit different angles because it's going to stretch the inside, the outside of the hip capsule and all that. So, I'm going to give you guys a view from the front. The first time we do the forward bow, now what I want you to do is I just want you to twist your chest towards one of the corners of the box. So, twist your chest. And then we're going to repeat that same bow, and you're going to feel this in a whole different area of the hip. One more time, you can go the advanced version, which will strengthen. Or if you absolutely need to, grab the box, and we're going to pull ourselves in. Okay? Of course, if we go inside, that means we have to go outside, so I'm going to twist my chest towards the outside corner, or towards my knee, and I'm going to re-bend. Now, it doesn't have to be an absolute crazy angle. You don't need to twist yourself up like a pretzel, but making sure that you go forward, inside, outside is going to hit different parts of that hip. And what I want you to do is I want you to do 2 to 3 rounds in about 3 to 5 minutes on this box. You're going to be amazed how much this helps your hip, especially if you struggle with performing hip stretches because you're really locked down here. Guys, this is your elevated box pigeon. It's taking what you've learned in yoga and advancing a little bit. So, if you enjoyed this video, can you go ahead and drop a thumbs up? If you got a question, comment below. And if you need to, share this with a friend, and I will see you guys in the next video.